Honey, aren't you going to eat any breakfast?
Oh, no, I'm too excited to eat.
Excited about what?
About what? This is my first trip into New York City since we moved to the country, and that was 6 whole weeks ago. I'll bet I won't even recognize the old place.
Well, it has changed a little. They got skyscrapers now.
Oh, you. You get to go into town every day while I'm stuck out here in the country.
What do you mean stuck? You're the one who wanted to move to the suburbs so you could get out of the dirty old city.
Oh, I like it out here. It's just that after 6 weeks of fresh, clean country air, a woman looks forward to one day of city dirt.
Can I go, Mommy?
No, honey. You're going to stay overnight with Bruce Ramsey.
Where can I go? I like dirt.
He likes dirt.
Well, honey, we're going to be out so late. Mommy and Daddy are going to go to see a show with Uncle Fred and Aunt Ethel.
What show?
It's called The Most Happy Fellow.
Can I see it sometime?
Well, you're a little bit too young for theater, partner.
Yeah, you can see it when you grow up, honey. At the rate they're selling tickets, it'll still be playing.
That's right. Say, will you do me a favor?
What?
Will you go out to the guest house and tell Uncle Fred that I'm about ready to leave?
Okay, Daddy.
Thank you.
Put your jacket on, honey.
Okay, Mommy.
Fred's going into town when you do, huh?
No. Today's his day to collect the rent at their apartment.
Oh.
Say, about the tickets now. You sure you know where they are?
Yes, honey, I'm sure. I put them in my dresser drawer in my jewel box with my good jewelry 6 months ago.
All right. And you won't forget to bring them with you.
Well, I thought I'd throw them in the wastebasket just before I left the house.
Just check it. Are you sure you got the right date?
Yes, honey, I'm sure I have the right date. I put a ring around the date on the calendar. I made a mental note of it. I entered it in my engagement book. I did everything but hire an elephant and tie a string around its trunk.
Yeah, but are you sure you got the right date?
Oh, honestly, Ricky, just this once, can't you give me credit for doing something right?
All right, now, don't get so touchy.
Well, honestly.
Well, you know how you are.
No, how am I?
Well, to tell you the truth, you're a little, you know.
Really?
Okay, I trust you.
Well, thanks a lot.
Listen, don't forget that Fred and I are going to meet you and Ethel at Megan's Chop House.
Okay.
7:30.
Yes, dear.
And be on time.
Yes, dear.
And don't go crazy shopping in all the stores.
No, dear.
Bye.
Goodbye, dear. Sheesh. Ethel, isn't it fun being in town for an evening?
Would you ladies care to order now?
Well, we're waiting for our husbands, but we do have to get to the theater, so maybe we better order something that doesn't take too long, huh? What's ready?
The roast beef's ready.
Well, how's that for you?
Oh, that's fine.
All right, 4 roast beefs, medium, with mashed potatoes and lima beans.
Oh, lima beans.
Okay.
Very well.
Oh, Lucy, just think we're going to go to the theater tonight.
How about that?
Where are we sitting?
6th row center, downstairs.
Let me see the tickets. I just like to hold mine for a while.
Oh, you silly.
I put them in my memory book. Now, Lucy, don't tell me you forgot them.
No, I did not forget them. Nobody seems to trust me anymore. Here they are. Oh. There you are. Row F, seats 104, 5, 6, and 7. What's the matter? What time is it, Ethel?
It's 7:40.
Why? Too late for the matinee, huh? Matinee? Oh, no.
Oh, Lucy, how could you?
Well, I wrote for the best seats on the first available Saturday. I forgot all about the matinee.
Oh, of all the dumb tricks.
Well, at least I didn't lose them. You'll have to admit that.
Well, bully for you.
Maybe we can get 4 more seats at the box office.
Oh, you know this show's been sold out for 6 months. Gee, it's too bad we didn't have tickets to a stinker.